like, you know, for like a kid, you know, from a fucked up home in Mississippi, like, you know, it was pretty mind blowing to know that, like, you know, like you could do something and like there were people all around the world, you know, who would be interested in. Like, that was a really weird thing, you know. Like, it was totally cool.
I mean, if you go home, you know, you're not on the football team or something, but you go home and you got a cassette.
Yeah, it's like, wow. I remember I got like a cassette from like Taiwan or something like one day. Like, some guy sent me a tape. I'm like, what is this? You know, like how did he find, like, why does this happen? You know, like, it was just crazy. And, you know, I had this band going with Jim Magus from Magus, you know, with his couch. And, you know, we started talking about it. We were like, yeah, we'd like to have a label. This would be cool. And we'll put out our band Couch, which we didn't even have a song or anything. We never even played a show. But yeah. Jim Magus, you know, he had like the best ideas ever. And he was the guy that came up with the name Bulb Records and came with the idea of like fashioning it after the Sun Records label.
Love it.
Because he was like, he's like, you know, a sun is everlasting, but a bulb can burn out at any minute.
I'd never heard that. Amazing.
That was it. You know, Quintron at the time just kind of sort of like split off from Math and just kind of kept doing the same thing he was doing before. He was playing percussion and like, and eventually like found an organ in the trash or something like that and started doing his organ thing. Not just never turned back, especially after he met Panacea. Like, you know, he, you know, became, you know, he was always always incredibly amazing, wonderful human being. And, you know, hooking up with Panacea like really took him, you know, to the great person that we know today. I saw them at a show with Guitar Wolf at Club Quattro in Osaka at the time, and I think it was like the first show, I want to say first or second show. Like, it was packed. I mean, it was like hundreds of people there, and they played and they were just absolutely amazing. I was like, oh my god, these guys are good. It was great.
Yeah. So tell me about the Pterodactyls.
I don't know what's the,
what was the concept? Why did the band form?
We had like Aaron Dillaway had this costume, and like he would be the Pterodactyl Man when he wore his costume, and we were like, oh, we have to form a band around this.
Talk about some of the other bands that you put out.
So I've put out two guys from Kenya, Macadam, who's my buddy stuck in Denmark right now. Grandmaster Masese, who plays the giant version of this. Did two singles for them. And then I also did an LP for this free jazz band called The Heart of the Ghost with Ian McCollum, Jared Gilgore, and Luke Stewart from Irreversible Entanglements. And I saw those guys on tour here in town. And it was like, to me, it was like seeing like the Minutemen. It was like, yeah, the free jazz version of the Minutemen. You know, they were just like three dudes like playing this like really aggressive form of free jazz, you know, but it was like, you know, grooving and like joyous and like everything, you know, like everything at the same time. And you couldn't help but like love all the noise that they were making, you know.
Awesome.
And, you know, they were totally like, you know, get in the van, just go wherever, you know, play anywhere. If you get $2, who cares, you know, like, you know, just the coolest dudes ever. You know, I gotta give a plug, right? You know, wear your damn mask. It's absolutely serious. You know, there's nothing wrong with putting a piece of cloth in front of your face. You know, to go into a store, if you work in a store, you should wear the cloth on your face. Definitely don't go hang out in bars. As much as I love to hang out in bars and love shows and all those kinds of things, like, they are just absolutely like, you know, the best place for COVID-19 to transmit. You know, if you don't want to get sick and you don't want to see your friends get sick, you'll stay out of the bars, you know, for sure. And I know that's hard for people. If you're going to hang out with people, go hang out in the backyard, sit outside, get some chairs, spread apart, you know, crack a few beers, you know, hang out, talk, do all the things that you do, you know, but, you know, this is a very serious time.
Totally.
Yeah. Cool, man. Thanks for talking to me again.
Dude, thanks for hanging again. It was totally fun.
Yeah, I really appreciate it. And we'll be in touch. We're looking forward to more from...